Back in St. Petersburg, Russia, a city that has undergone three revolutions, three name changes, and a 900-day siege during the course of the 20th century. Nothing quite as dramatic tonight, but Cup of Russia continues inside the Sports and Concert Complex. The original dance portion of this event about to get underway. And the overall Grand Prix standings look like this. The Italians, Fuscipoli and Morgaglio, will see them at the Grand Prix final. They've had a great year so far. Drobiazko and Vanagas of Lithuania, we should see them in Lyon, France as well. The top five ice dance teams make it to the series final. Well, the skaters on the ice warming up for the original dance. There's a look at the favorites coming in. The Canadian national champions and the four-time world bronze medalist Shailen Bourne and Victor Kratz. But an upset in the making because they are not in first place. They're in second right now after the compulsory dance, right behind the Italians that we mentioned. Barbara Fuscipoli, her partner Maurizio Morgaglio, they are in first. They've already had a win this season in the Grand Prix. And a look at those standings after the compulsory dance. The Italians on top of the Canadians right now. Then in third place, a good battle going on for that between the team from Poland, Novak and Kolesinski, and Dubray and Lausanne of Canada. But to start this original dance, and they look ready right now. From Russia, in front of this home crowd, Anna Semenovich and Roman Kostomarov.
Hopefully they'll heat up this skating rink, Terry.
Little chilly in here.
They've only been skating together for 5 months, and really, they've come together quite nicely as a dance team.
Larry Gannon, Susie Wynn with you ringside. Where it is maybe 40 degrees, that's about it.
The original program is 3 minutes in length. Last season it was 2 minutes. Lots of rule changes. Five required elements, two dance lifts, two step sequences, and a dance spin.
Ice dancing, of course, the only discipline in which the skaters compete three times throughout an event. Compulsory dance, this original dance, and then the free dance, which, by the way, you can see over on Lifetime Friday evening beginning at 9 o'clock Eastern, along with the finals of the pairs competition. The original dance, 3 minutes in length and worth 30% of the overall score.
Their first dance lift. Look, he's in a spread eagle position. That's very hard to balance in that position. Very nice.
Roman actually grew up in Moscow, and they have known each other for most of their lives. They were childhood friends. Now live and train in Newark, Delaware, and their coach, Natalia Linichuk, actually put them together this past summer. They were previously skating with other partners.
Well, they certainly bring that samba rhythm alive. The dancers are allowed to pick two or three selections of music, the cha-cha, mambo, merengue, rumba, and samba. And they certainly have a lot of energy. They're fun to watch.
And a lot of support here, too. Russian flags flying high. Anna Semenovich and Roman Kostomarov from Russia.
This, their second dance lift, one of the required elements in the original dance, goes to a very high level, very hard to balance. Watch how he's in a, what's called a spread eagle position. That takes tremendous balance, nice flexibility. Well done. And here you could just see the energy. It really reaches out to the audience. It's almost choreographed with all of their steps as well.
Check the marks now. First of two sets for composition. 4.9 to 5.2.
Well, they skated everything very well at this point. Some of their unison was a little off. Because they are a new team, that's where that will affect their skating.
Presentation, well, those are higher. You can hear from the reaction of the crowd. 5.1 to 5.4 for the Russian team, and this thing started here in the original dance. When we come back, the leaders after the compulsory dance, Barbara Fuster-Poli and Maurizio Morgaglio take the ice as Cup of Russia continues. Back in St. Petersburg with the six-time Italian national champions, Barbara Fuster-Poli and Maurizio Morgaglio in first place after the compulsory dance, trying to pull off an upset here in St. Petersburg. Born and Kratz are in second. The Italians have already won this season. That was at Skate America. They finished second at Trophy La Ligue. They're guaranteed a spot in the Grand Prix final. This is a non-scoring competition for them, but awfully important if they can complete the upset over the Canadians.
Terry, what I really sense from this couple is confidence, speed, flow. They look very comfortable in their partnering. They've been really fun to watch because they've improved so much. Really fast circle sequence there. Very comfortable with this cha-cha rhythm, using a lot of holds and passes from the ballroom floor.
At the risk of overstating the upset theme here, but you know how slow change is in the world of ice dance. Is there a shift in maybe the perception?
Well, I think maybe, Terry. At Skate America, everyone was shocked that they were able to pull ahead of Lebesheva and Averbuch, but they really deserved it. Here in the compulsories, it could have gone either way. The Canadians did look very smooth. Both couples were very equal in the compulsory. It's fun to see the change. Now, as they head into their straight line footwork, they go in with tons of speed. Most couples have opted to take it from a stopping position, so they've got lots of speed, good coordination. Their twizzles are in coordination, Terry. That is one turn on one foot, rather.
Love when you point out those twizzles, Susan.
Very difficult lift there. She somersaults through his arm. Another great performance by these two. They really are coming alive this season and coming into their own. It's fun to watch.
First and a second place finish already this season for Barbara Fuster-Poli and Maurizio Morgaglio. They picked up $48,000 in those two events. Trying to pick up another check for $30,000 here in St. Petersburg.
Terry, maybe they could take us to dinner tonight.
I'm for it.
You can really see their great unison.
They're skating very close together. Look, she somersaults through his arm. That's very dangerous because her foot comes very close to his arm. To see the energy between them, they really work well together, and that confidence is really shining through in their performance here in the original dance.
So the marks now, the first set for composition. 5.4 up to 5.7.
And these marks are higher than they were at Lalique. Their range in Lalique was 5.2 to 5.4.
Where they placed second last week in Paris. Now for presentation, 5.5 up to 5.8 the range for Barbara Fusser-Poli and Maurizio Morgaglio, the leaders after the compulsory dance. So far, they are still in that place. And on the ice next, from Canada, Shailen Bourne and Victor Kratz will skate as we continue here in St. Petersburg. Back inside the Sports and Concert Complex here in St. Petersburg, Russia, Shailen Bourne and Victor Kratz from Canada, the seven-time Canadian national champions. In second place, heading into this original dance.
Terry, really a goal for them is to try to make some ground here in the original dance by skating very clean and doing what they could do best, which is smooth, beautiful skating. Beautiful edging there. It's very deep, very round lobes. The judges are really looking to see if dancers have that capability. Very pretty short lift, very difficult because they're in very low positions to the ice. Their speed and their unison has really improved since Nations Cup. Just a little bit of time to get some of the kinks worked out. This is their dance spin and Killian position. He has one arm around her back. Killian position is just a dance hold. Their circular footwork for difficult steps, interesting holds, and speed.
Four-time world bronze medalist. They're the only ice dance team to do that. I'd like to put a stop to that. Move up in the standings this year at the World Championships. Opportunities for all ice dance teams because the world champions, Krylova and Ovsyannikov, have not competed due to Angelika's back injury this season.
Really watch for their unison, watch their feet. They're doing some difficult turns, some mirror work. Again, it still needs to move out a little fast. Sometimes you have to go for the speed and quiet down on the difficulty if it slows you up a little bit. But much sharper than Nations Cup. It is coming together. They're gaining that confidence that they'll need this season. It looks like they're going to have some friendly competition from the Italians.
Friendly competition, huh? Yeah, I guess so. They won at Nations Cup, by the way, but as you said, they weren't quite as sharp as at least you expected them to be. But a great battle shaping up here between Fusser-Poli and Morgaglio and Shailen Bourne and Victor Kratz of Canada.
This team skates with great smoothness in their knees. They get really low into their ankle and knee flexion. Here they go into their opening lift, She hooks onto his feet. He's in a nice low position. Great balancing, beautiful shape. And their final lift, nice hook in here, nice and close. Pretty attitude shape for her. Lots of chiffon. And they go down into a move which we call hydroblading. You're just skimming the ice with the blade. They've made that popular.
Okay, I'm going to put you on the spot now. Between the two, the Italians and the Canadians, who would you put in first right now?
Well, as much as I like the Canadians, I really feel that the Italians gave it more speed. They have three rhythms in their original dance, and they display them so well. Vic and Shaylin's skate with more of a smooth quality doesn't come across as much.
If the judges agree with you. Composition 5.2 to 5.6.
They perform this very well. Again, their confidence level needs to come up, but it was much sharper, much cleaner than Nations Cup.
Presentation marks now. The range there, 5.3 up to 5.7. So, hey, guess what? You agree with the judges. Born in Kratz in second place behind Fustropoli and Morgaglia right now of Italy. When we come back, Sylvia Novak and Sebastian Koleszynski of Poland take the ice as the original dance continues from Russia. And welcome back to St. Petersburg. The original dance continues. Terry Gannon, Susie Wynn. She's the one with the hat. It is freezing in here. What's the deal with this?
I know what to get you for Christmas. You need a hat and sweater set, Terry.
Yeah, not matching. I do like the lid, though. It works.
Hey, you need it. I'm not complaining.
Just like the old days when they held these events outdoors. Sylvia Novak and Sebastian Koleszynski, the five-time champions of Poland. They are in third place after the compulsory dance. Puerto Rico!
This couple starting us off with a merengue. It's a very fast tempo, and they have lots of great energy. Nice unison in there. First step sequence, it's a straight line. It goes corner to corner.
They are already one of the most accomplished dance teams that Poland has ever produced. Finished ninth at the World Championships last season. Came in fourth at Trophy Lalique last week in Paris.
There. And in ice dancing, you really can't afford those. They make things look messy.
Remember this, the second of three portions of this competition, an ice dance, a free dance, comes your way over on Lifetime, Friday night, beginning at 9 o'clock Eastern.
I spoke with Sylvia and Sebastian about the rules and how they felt about it. They feel a little restricted. They said normally they feel the music dictates the movement. In this case, they felt like they had to keep considering the rules, and that made it hard for them to choreograph.
Yes.
in third after the compulsory dance, right behind the Italians and the Canadians. A little extra after the music stops. From Sylvia Novak and Sebastian Kolaschinski.
They certainly have high spirits, lots of expression. They just had a little bobble in the middle of their program and not the difficulty of the other couples.
We'll have their marks when we return to Cup of Russia here in St. Petersburg. Back at the Cup of Russia, the original dance. And now the scores for Sylvia Novak and Sebastian Kolaschinski of Poland. 5.1 to 5.6, the range for composition.
Well, some of the low marks really due to the fact that their difficulty is lacking. Some of their lifts are just very dated, very small.
And now for presentation, 5.3 to 5.6, so Novak and Kolaschinski in third behind Born and Kratz of Canada. The final skaters take the ice here in the original dance. From Canada, Marie-France Dubray and Patrice Lazon. In fourth place after the compulsory.
This couple just goes together. They look like each other and they skate like each other. Really good match. Very interesting way of they incorporating the rules into that lift. Very creative. Lots of variation.
You mentioned the rules. Compared to the time when Torvald and Dean skated, how much more restrictive are the rules now?
Well, the rules just keep changing. Torvald and Dean really did their best to work around the rules. When British are great, when they receive the year's rules, they look at ways of breaking them. Americans and North Americans look at ways of obeying them. So there's two schools of thought on that. But the rules just keep changing, and they are strict.
Send your letters to Susie Wynn at ABC Sports.
Oh, no. I'm in trouble now. What I really like about this couple is they move what we say in ballroom, their rib cages. They don't stay stiff in their upper body. They really release, open, and contract, which is indicative of Latin dancing. And they do that very well. Breaking into their circular footwork. Lots of difficulty here. They're oftentimes facing one another, which is harder than facing the same direction. Interchanging here. Terry at Skate Canada, remember, they had a hard time with this skirt. It kept getting in their way and tripped them up a bit. Looks like she's taken a couple of inches off of it.
It does look shorter, doesn't it?
It does. Their last selection is a samba, the dance of Brazil. It's a festival dance. The straight line footwork can be two arm lengths apart. No holding on, so the judges can check out each dancer's individual abilities. A fun lift. Has a lot of momentum. Great control there.
Four must be their number. Fourth place the last 3 years at the Canadian National Championships. Came in fourth at Skate Canada. They were in fourth after the compulsories here. Marie-France Dubray and Patrice Lazon.
But check their final lift out. It's fast. It's furious. Look how far away she is from his body. That creates a lot of momentum. That's hard to control, and they incorporate that into their final position. That's great choreography and beautiful skating.
And, of course, as you said before, the biggest improvement in their skating, the shorter skirt. Marie-France Dubray. First set of marks for composition, 4.6 to 5.1.
I think some of these are a little bit low, Terry. They did have a lot of difficulty. It does need to move out. However, they have beautiful lifts and great footwork.
Second set now for presentation.
I think that 4.4 is a little bit low. And the British judge, they really did perform this well, put their heart and soul into it. That's what gets discouraging about ice dance judging.
But the upset bid at the top continues. The Italians, Fischer-Poli and Morgaglio, still in the lead over Shailen Bourne and Viktor Kratz heading into the free dance. Novak and Kolesinski, of course, in third. They have edged out Semenovic and Kostomarov of Russia so far. So the standing set for that free dance comes your way Friday evening over on Lifetime, beginning at 9 o'clock Eastern, along with the finals of the pairs competition. More to come tonight from St. Petersburg, though. The ladies' turn when we come back, including Arina Slutskaya of Russia, trying to get back to the top. She's a two-time European champion, trying to hold off the younger generation, too. Fellow Russian, Yulia Soldatova, the world's bronze medalist, will take the ice as well. And Angela Nikodinov, the U.S. bronze medalist, trying to keep this from becoming a completely Russian block party here in St. Petersburg. The ladies take the ice for their short program next when we come back to Cup of Russia.